Hi, my name is Eleanor, and my friend Maria, I've known her for about 12 years, and I'm very grateful and thankful for her friendship. I'm glad that I'm here today to enjoy her birthday party with her family, and I pray that God will continue to bless her, and that she will have peace, joy, and many more years. Thank you, Maria, for being my dear friend. I love you, and I wish you the best.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mom, I want to wish you a happy birthday, and I love you so much.
I want to wish you a happy birthday, maligayang ang bati, feliz cumpleaños. I love you very much, despite my unusual behavior as your son, but nevertheless, I love you, and happy birthday. Take care.
I want to wish you a happy birthday. I'm glad to see that your sons are here because they're very important. I'm sorry to see that your other one's not here, but I know that in spirit he's thinking about you. Because as a son myself, we can never say enough about our mothers. One of the things that we have when we're growing up is we always think that other things or other places are better, then realize what home really is until you're out there. And I think that when your sons continue to grow and experience life and see, you know, truly what love you have for them and what love they have for you. I'm glad that I've been able to spend all these years with you and just indirectly, you know, like any brother and sisters, we have our differences. But at the end, you know, as a family, we always come together, and I think that's good. I think that I show the remarkable tolerance by the way we were brought up in circumstances when our bringing up. We had a really inspirational person as a parent who showed us what hard work is, and, you know, love for one's family is also. And I think that, you know, if anything, both your boys and your brothers and sisters always know where you're at when it comes to that. So I just want to wish you a great 54, isn't it? And congratulations on living that much, you know, longer, and here's for the next 50 years. So bless you and I love you.
I want to thank you for organizing this. You're such a busy person, and in your own way, you're a very business-minded person. You don't like to waste time. You're always on the run, and God has blessed you with that skill to be able to afford all those different ventures you're involved in. And this year, you decided to stop your activities to call your family, call your children, and just celebrate life. Celebrate your life. I believe that bonding is the most important thing we could do with one another. It's as old as cavemen. Cavemen sat around a bush of fire and ate together. That was bonding. And you know, in America, we don't do that anymore. Everybody's eating in their own little space. Even when we're together, we have a TV on or we're reading newspapers or whatever. Thank you for reminding us the importance of stopping what we do, especially on a Saturday. We're all busy. But you chose a day like today to say, let's stop and let's sit together and remember. I'm really proud of you because you're a very caring person. You have a very interesting way of showing your affections, but that's what makes you different. I think when I think of you, I think of your middle name, Betseba. It's a kind of weird name. In fact, I've never knew anyone called Betseba. Back when I was a little kid, I couldn't even pronounce your name. And you were clever enough to tell us, call me Betsy. Oh, okay, Betsy. Because I couldn't say Betseba. And I think that kind of made a remarkable influence on your psyche. Because everything you do, like the place where we're at today, is not very Mexican. But it's very Maria. Maria would only do something like this because Maria is different. And I think her two boys are very different. And they're just like the mother. Different, special. They want to stand out. Because I think my dad decided to do something to you. He did it when he gave you your name, Betseba, Maria Betseba. And so on this day, I thank God because he's given us life. Last night I was in an emergency room with my 16-year-old who was very ill. And there I sat in this waiting room looking at all these sick people, young, old, babies of all ages. And I realized, you know, life is short. Tomorrow, right now I'm grieving for my child. Tomorrow I'm going to be celebrating with my sister because tomorrow's her birthday. And that's life. So we need to cling to the people we love. You're the person that we love. And we need to say it. Because, you know, when our time passes, and it will come, we're going to mourn you. And some of us are going to cry out and scream out. But I hope most of us will be remembering each and every one of us in a very pleasant way. Like the way we're gathered here today. Remembering Maria for really what she is. Maria, very special person. A very unique person. Hard-working person. Hard-working person. And a person who deeply cares about her family in her own way. Because she has her own way of expressing it. So I love you, Maria. I'm right behind you. So you're 54. I'm gonna be 53. Am I gonna be 53? I don't even know. I'm gonna be 53. And so many more birthdays, many more happy times. And you know what? You know we have setbacks in life. Sure. But you know what? You need to be able to switch off, turn off that bad moment and just move on. Always moving on, never looking back. I love you very much. I pray that God grant you all the petitions of your heart. Happy birthday.
Maria, de pequeña, era una niña hermosa. Ella era una niña que toda la gente la quería, porque era muy cariñosa. Se iba con toda la gente que la quería agarrar. Siempre se distinguió en el sentido de que ella siempre fue muy estudiosa. Ella se graduó antes de tiempo de la high school y emprendió para trabajar como enfermera. Yo era el raite de ella, la llevaba al trabajo, la traía al trabajo, y a veces trabajaba hasta dos trabajos. Ella tenía una ilusión por, yo creo que es algo que ya tiene uno, pero ella se distinguió en el sentido de que fue emprendedora, una persona muy ahorrativa, una persona que de ver a Dios de una manera especial la protegió. Fue una joven que ella escogía a los novios y cuando ella se casaba. Ella fue un dolor en cierto sentido cuando se casó con su esposo, el primer esposo, los padres de su jovencito, y se fue a las Filipinas. Llevaba como 7 maletas, porque dijo: yo no voy a regresar, yo me voy a las Filipinas y no voy a quedar. Pero resulta que no aguantó porque allá llovía mucho, era un país diferente. Y ella regresó. Y cuando ella regresó, ella dijo: ahora sí me voy a quedar aquí, mamá. Emprendedora, porque empezó a comprar propiedades. Ella empezó a pensar en el futuro. Yo le doy gracias a Dios porque María ha sido una joven que, en el sentido de que hay problemas con los hijos, ella fue muy estudiosa. Yo le doy gracias a Dios por todos mis hijos. Pero en este momento mi mente se trasladó al pasado. Después de que su padre se murió, yo tenía que lidiarla a ella, en el sentido de que la llevaba para todas partes, la llevaba y la traía. Y le doy gracias a Dios porque aquí están todos mis hijos, con excepción de una de mis hijas. Pero quiero decirte, hijita, que te amo con todo el corazón. Y oro por ti, que Dios te bendiga. Ese es mi deseo.
Pray that God always takes care of you and that you have peace and you have health in your life. And that your children appreciate who you are and that they love you and they respect you. Because one doesn't ask to be born, but I believe that God, He forms families. And when He was forming your family, He gave you Jason and Myron and Kaysir. And those are your children. And just like God gave my mother, you as a daughter. And He forced us as brothers and sisters. So today on your birthday, I love birthdays, because that's the day you come together and you celebrate that person's life. And so I say happy birthday. God bless you. I love you very much. And I'm glad to be here. Happy birthday, Liam.